In case you haven't heard or been on the internet a lot recently, there's a seriously big beef going down right now between Eminem and Machine Gun Kelly. Eminem dissed Machine Gun Kelly over something he did years ago. Then Machine Gun Kelly heard this and fired back with a diss track called Rap Devil.
Somebody help your mans up. Help. Knees weak or old age. The real Slim Shady can't stand up.
Which Eminem fired back with his kill shot.
Yeah, I had enough money in 02 to burn it in front of you. Younger me, no, you'd have whacked me.
It's funny but so true.
I'd rather be 80-year-old me than 20-year-old you.
But the question remains, was Machine Gun Kelly's track even good in the first place? Join me as I break down everything that is wrong with Rap Devil.
Somebody grab him some clippers. My beard is weird.
Number 7. Dissing his looks. Really? It's common knowledge that when you do a diss track, just about anything is up for grabs in terms of dissing material. Their songs, their lives, their quotes, and etc. But one of the things you have to be careful of when you diss someone is dissing their clothes. Why? Because in this modern age of rappers and singers, one person's style is another's ugliness. And looking at the fashion of people like 6ix9ine, Nicki Minaj, and more, you really have to be careful about what you say about another person's look. But Machine Gun Kelly clearly did not care about that, because he actually starts off the actual disses with a jab at Eminem's beard. And he doesn't say it's trash or lame, or that Eminem noted in the past that he hated beards multiple times. No, he just said it was weird.
A beard is weird.
That's it? That's all you have to say about the beard? Machine Gun Kelly needs to get a little more creative about his insults. But naturally, he doesn't stop there. He went back and took a shot at how Eminem used to dress back in the early 2000s by saying, "I'm sick of those sweatsuits and them corny hats." While he may have a point about the jumpsuits, you have to remember this was 2000 to 2010. You know, where Eminem was the best-selling artist in the world? Yeah. Furthermore, he dressed that way to try and make a brand for himself, which worked. And what's wrong with a hat? It's a hat. Machine Gun Kelly has worn hats. Are they corny by default? I don't think he would see it that way. So seriously, why insult his fashion sense? Where does that get him? And as Eminem pointed out in his rebuttal diss track, Killshot, Machine Gun Kelly used to have a man bun. So who is he the judge? Number 6. What's the music video about? Let's move on to the music video, which is honestly one of the more confusing elements of the entire diss track. Why? Because it's just Machine Gun Kelly in an alley rapping about him and Eminem. And he's eating out of a bowl? Why? What's the significance of that? Or how about in certain frames where he's yelling at a truck grill? What was he trying to convey there? Like, granted, not everything is misconstrued. He carries a shovel for a part of the video, which is clearly an emphasis that he's trying to bury Slim Shady. But the rest of it, not so much. What this is all saying is that the budget for this video was low. I mean, they likely didn't have to pay for the rights to use the street in that video. The bowl and the spoon were cheap, the shovel too. The trucks might have cost something, we don't know. And the edit was really simple. Was he trying to make an easy video? Why wouldn't he just go all out on this video to prove that he was better than Eminem? In feuds, you shouldn't wait for a second chance. You should just go for the knockout in the first move. Even if you're going second like Machine Gun Kelly did here, but he didn't. Not in the lyrics. And definitely not in the music video. Number 5. Incorrect facts. In Rap Devil, Machine Gun Kelly sings, "Still can't cover up the fact. Your last 4 albums is as bad as your selfie." Here's the problem. The last 4 albums by Eminem before Kamikaze were Revival, the Marshall Mathers LP 2, Recovery, and Relapse. Both Recovery and Relapse were actually successful, and Recovery alone got Billboard fame and Grammy Awards. As for Relapse, while it wasn't a major success, it was still double platinum. And it was number 1 on the Billboard Top 100, and it got a Grammy Award for Best Rap Album. So if you said your last 2 albums sucked, that would be accurate. But last 4? Not so much. Number 4. Devil versus God. Hierarchy is a key thing in many cultures, especially when it comes to gods. Zeus, Odin, Osiris, and others are the top dogs of their pantheons. And in the Christian religion, God is the beginning and the end. And yet, Machine Gun Kelly thinks it's cooler to be called the Rap Devil in contrast to Eminem, who is the Rap God. One problem. God is greater than the devil. In Christian religion, the devil was named Lucifer and was God's most beloved and most trusted angel. And yet he turned away from the path set for him. And thus God casted him out of heaven and into the underworld, making him suffer for all eternity. So why would Machine Gun Kelly think it's better off to be the Rap Devil? Granted, if he left the religious aspect out of it, you could take it like he's the devil with his words, spewing out fire and hate and all that, which would be good for a diss track. But he says that Eminem is the Rap God, which by default makes him lesser than Eminem if he's the rap devil. Know your role, Machine Gun Kelly. Know your role.
Mad about something I said in 2012, took you 6 years and a surprise album just to come with a diss.
Number 3, the intent of a song. In Machine Gun Kelly's eyes, the Eminem track Not Alike was about a comment he made back in 2012. During a post on Twitter, he noted that Eminem's daughter was smoking hot, even though she was only 16. Eminem is very protective of his children, and he took great offense to this, as others did. But the fact of the matter is, Not Alike didn't touch on that comment. It talked about what Machine Gun Kelly had done in recent terms of his music. He didn't even bring it up at all. In fact, the rebuttal to Rap Devil, Killshot, talked more about that comment than Not Alike did, which means that he didn't even pay attention to the song that Eminem was singing. Which brings us to another issue. Machine Gun Kelly thinks that all of Kamikaze was about him. It wasn't. Machine Gun Kelly was named in one track. 1 out of 13! Eminem was on a rampage of sorts, insulting all the current industry, more or less. Especially the young guns like Machine Gun Kelly, who are trying to make a name for themselves. So he didn't just focus on MGK, he went all out on many other people, including large legions of his critics. So again, Machine Gun Kelly doesn't realize that aside from that 20-second spot, Kamikaze wasn't about him. Which means, technically, Rap Devil shouldn't even exist. And just as bad, Machine Gun Kelly brings up the comment about the daughter multiple times, and doesn't even seem sorry for saying it, despite it being wrong when he said it back in 2012.
Homie, we get it. We know that you're the greatest rapper alive.
Number 2. Is he dissing him or not? You cannot have a diss track with mixed signals. It literally doesn't work. So imagine my surprise when I see Machine Gun Kelly actually asking Eminem to talk about it, with him and Rap Devil.
I'm sick of you being rich and you still mad, let's talk about it.
Say what now? Oh yeah, he does that multiple times. In fact, it's the damn chorus of the song. I'm sick of them sweatsuits and them corny hats. Let's talk about it. I'm sick of you being rich and you still mad. Let's talk about it. Both of us singles dad from the Midwest. We can talk about it. So basically, he went from insulting Eminem to wanting to play Peacemaker. How does that work? How? Where? And isn't this going against what a diss track is? It's bipolar as hell. Shouldn't you want to be putting your foe into the ground 6 feet under? Put some chalk around it? Not put them on the other side of a diplomatic table? Granted, he does acknowledge that if Eminem doesn't want peace, they can have a fight and Machine Gun Kelly will put him down for good. But that was only after offering to call this whole thing off. Again, that's not how it works. What's more, despite this being a diss track, he actually compliments Eminem by saying, "Homie, we get it. We know that you're the greatest rapper alive." Factual, this is true. Or at the very least, close to true. Eminem is considered one of the greatest rappers alive. As noted previously, he was the best-selling artist in the world from 2000 to 2010, which is quite an impressive thing. But you don't admit that to the guy in a diss track. You're trying to win a battle, not give your opponent props. An easy fix would have been, "Why do people think you're the greatest rapper alive?" And then he could have gone down a long list of disses stating why he's not. But he doesn't. He goes fanboy, of which he is one to Eminem, and basically thanks him for what he's done for the genre. That's not what you're supposed to do. Why did he think this was a good idea?
You sober and bored, huh? I know. I'm about to be 46 years old, dog.
Number 1. Dissing Eminem getting clean. That's wrong. There's a lot of stereotypes out there in the music world. Rappers are associated with violence more times than not. And they're also associated with drugs more times than not as well, even when undeservingly. But the fact is, despite the lifestyle stating that they have it, not all do. And while it's true that Eminem used to do drugs, he doesn't do them anymore. In fact, he was happy to show off that he's been sober for over 10 years recently. Which, for anyone who has done drugs or alcohol, knows that's a long time for a former addict. But does Machine Gun Kelly respect Eminem for choosing to live a better life? A healthier life? No. Instead, he says this.
You sober and bored, huh? I know.
So basically, he says that it's uncool to be sober? And the bored line can be taken in many different ways. The literal bored, as in he had nothing better to do, and thus to make a kamikaze out of the blue, or that his lifestyle and life are boring because he doesn't do drugs and such anymore. If he had just done, "You're bored, huh?" that would be okay. Because to be fair, Eminem hasn't had a lot of success with his last two albums before Kamikaze, and so that's a fair diss. But to incorporate his sobriety into the diss, that's crossing a line that even a diss track shouldn't cross. Eminem almost died because of an overdose. After all, he has a daughter, and he wants to be around for her. How wrong is that? Hey, just a reminder that we're changing up the giveaways. From now on, we're offering the Galaxy Note 9, the one that comes with the exclusive Fortnite skin, the new iPhone X Max, which we'll pre-order for you, and the new Apple Watch Series 4, which we'll also pre-order for you. The winner gets to decide between these three. Make sure to subscribe, turn on notifications, drop a like, and comment the hidden message in the video for a chance to win. You got nothing to lose. Go for it.